from Joanna. We go to Kinga Lohmann, that comes from Poland, and she will flesh out what she thinks from that perspective, from that sub-region, is the most important issues to tackle.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am very happy to be here because CARAT, my organization which I represent, was conceived at the Beijing conference, and we participated in the whole process of monitoring the implementation of the Platform for Action. CARAT is a feminist network of women's organizations from 25 countries from the region of Central and Eastern Europe and Central Asia. And today, except Central Asia, a half of the countries are part of EU, called EU13, and the second half of the region aspire to be a member of the European Union. So I would like to just describe what is the region when they, what I represent. 20 years after Beijing conference, I would like to highlight what we as NGO networks see as three main concerns facing women's rights in the region. First, the serious attack on the ultra-conservative circle and some churches on the principle of gender equality, the simultaneous weakening of institutional mechanisms for women's rights and gender equality, and third, the continuous present and re-emergence of militarism, nationalism, and armed conflict in our region with the serious repercussion on the women's human rights. 20 years after Beijing conference, awareness about gender equality and women's discrimination has clearly increased, and the issues like, for example, violence against women are no longer taboo. However, greater public attention for gender also has caused resistance. We are currently facing serious intensive attack of ultra-conservative circles and some churches on the principle of gender equality, LGBT rights, which are presented as so-called gender ideology, and a major threat for family values. Instead, the protagonists of anti-feminist demand a reinforcing of traditional social roles of women and men, and oppose all kinds of gender equality policy, including combating violence against women. Unfortunately, we are not witnessing a strong reaction of national authorities to counteract the anti-gender campaign. Institutional mechanisms for women's rights and gender equality, although in place in most countries around the region, are too weak to effectively act. Moreover, the equal treatment approach, obligation of the context of EU membership and candidacy to adopt overall anti-discrimination legislation often has the effect of diminishing attention to gender equality. When all grounds of discrimination are merged, and gender is one of the grounds, into the task of one independent body, de facto it means the attention to gender equality is diminished. At the same time, women's rights organizations see big challenges in their activities of lobbying and advocacy for effective policy on women's rights or their watchdog function towards national machinery and governments. Cuts in financial support for NGO watchdog activities mean that many organizations did not survive in EU13 in the last 10 years. In some Eastern European and Central Asian countries, NGOs, including women's rights organizations, are threatened by existing or proposed laws against NGOs that received foreign funding, obligating them to register as foreign agents and comply with several requirements difficult to fulfill. A strong feminist movement is crucial for increasing the influence on policy and institutional mechanisms for gender equality and women's empowerment. 20 years after Beijing, unfortunately, armed conflict, militarism, and violent nationalism continue to be areas of concern in our region. Today, our region is experiencing escalating political tension in response to popular struggle for democratic change in Ukraine. We are concerned about the impacts of the Ukrainian crisis in Europe, the prospect of democracy, human rights, and gender equality. Unfortunately, the voices of women on this crisis are often marginalized from public discussion and reporting. In the face of the Ukrainian crisis, CARAT has initiated a regional women's conversation on the current Ukrainian crisis in the form of questionnaire that we sent out to our members and other women's rights activities. I would like to summarize some key highlights from received response from Ukraine and other countries. First highlight is about traditional value and nationalism as a threat to human rights and gender equality. Respondents fear that women's rights and gender equality are being pushed aside as less important than other topics, such as military conflict, economic chaos, national interest. They also fear that gender equality is threatened by the rise of nationalism and so-called traditional values. Second highlights, violence, sexual violence against women. All of the responses, if one way or another, see women as at great risk of violence, including sexual violence. There is no public debate on the impact of the military conflict on women's human rights. Respondents are concerned that the issues of violence against women in Ukraine during the current conflict may never be addressed or with very long delay, as it was the case in other countries. The third highlight is about women and in peace building, and I would like, because I have to finish, to come to the last one, the solidarity of women. One extremely strong message came across from the responses, the wish of women from different parts of the region to demonstrate active solidarity with Ukrainian women, and the belief that this solidarity has to also involve women from other parts of the world, particularly the rest of Europe and US. Our respondent came up with a very concrete suggestion for joint action and exchange. And I would like to quote the one response from Azerbaijan. We would like to implement women's regional project, which would cover all the conflict region, Russia, Ukraine, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Georgia, Moldova. The project should create a coalition of NGO and networks to carry out training in conflict resolution and citizen diplomacy. Thank you.